Price and for twice. First from the heat, then from your electricity bill. Did it come into your mind that PV is working hard when you need the air conditioning the most? Watch this video. You can finally relax and just turn on the air conditioner the whole day without thinking twice. And I will explain also why this is not wasting energy. Cool air is a gift from the sun. Hi, Norbert here. I'm an energy engineer. In video number 106, I explain how to use your air conditioner without paying the electricity. So it's 34 degrees Celsius. Charlie is hiding in the fridge. And I want my air conditioner on during the sunny hours, but not my electricity bill going through the roof.
Oh no!
I know, I was a bit critical during the last video about air conditioners. And indeed, they are the part of the problem. However, many people have them and they need them. Now, I will help you to control the costs. If a kilowatt hour costs you as much as here in Europe, you pay a couple of euros each day, each hot day. What if I told you that two humble solar panels that cost me less than a pizza weekend in Florence could run my air conditioner for free during 5 years? Let's see if this is a genius move or a beautiful disaster. These monsters here are 430 watts each. I paid only 68 euros for each, cheaper than dinner for two with wine. Together, 860 volts. That's enough to run this common air conditioner of 280 euros. But even if it's not enough, either because the sun is covered by a little bit of clouds, or for example when the air conditioner is starting to cool a warm room, or it's very hot outside, it is flexibly integrated with the grid. Thanks to the microinverter, it's a seamless cooperation between the grid and the PV. Every volt that the solar is not able to deliver will just come from your home grid. This microinverter Hoymiles HM600 that enables me to send solar energy directly through a plug into the wall. It's rated for 200-300 watts panels. So yes, I am technically overdriving because each of my panels is rated 50% more than these 300 watts for each input. Why on earth did I choose for such big panels? That's because, for example, on a cloudy day, the last hour before sunset, or also during the winter, I will still have many hours in a year with full power, or 2 times 300 volts, 600 volts. So the price for the panels was no reason to refrain myself. Talia's tu prezzo, as they say in Sicily. By the way, if you want to know how much energy you make with a solar panel on a sunny summer day, multiply the nominal power of the panel by 5 full hours. So with 860 watts and no inverter limitation of 300 times 2, that would be 4,300 watt hours or 4.3 kilowatt hour. That's here more or less 1 euro per day. With two panels of 300 watt, which is then equivalent with this limitation of the inverter, it would be only 3 kilowatt hours per day. But in the middle situation, when you have this panels of 860 watt and you have the limitation, so only a part of the hours are limited by this 300 watt for each input gate of the inverter, that's between 3 and 4.3 kilowatt hours. So we stay in the middle of those two values. So let's say 3.6 kilowatt hours per day. So a little bit more than 1 euro. And this I do with the two panels plus a microinverter with a total investment of 270 euros. And with the energy meter I come to 300. I think this energy meter you want to buy too. But contrary to my previous video with the microinverter, that was video number 100, I don't spend on the battery because the air conditioner is on practically always when the sun is shining. And by the way, to explain why this whole day utilization of the air conditioner is not a waste of energy, is because this house, all the walls, they are your battery. So if you let work the air conditioner when you are maybe not in the room, or when maybe the temperature is already okay, you just let it go, because every kilowatt hour is used well and invested well. If you use this configuration with solar and air conditioning only during the 3 summer months, then you save only 90 euros per year. But if you use it also during the rest of the year and you are able to consume all the energy instead of letting it flow away through the public grid, then you are close to a payback time of 1 year. So in some way, this optimal situation where you have really the ideal combination between the air conditioning and the solar panels is a kind of a sponsor situation. It allows you to justify this purchase, and then as a bonus, you have this panel for the rest of the coming 20-25 years. So then you are in this nice situation that you are starting with solar energy, even if you don't have on the roof this big system. So it's really a kind of step-in situation where this combination of technology is helping you to justify this purchase. Okay, and there you have such an unusual application. A microinverter with panels which are seriously over-dimensioned. Some of those trespasses which I like so much. People are scared to mismatch components, but if they give in to this worry, then they lose on those benefits. Now watch closely. My AC takes about 700 watts when it is just maintaining the temperature at 25 degrees, while outside it is rather hot. 25 degrees Celsius is a good temperature. I am not a penguin, and guess when you need it the most? Exactly when the sun is shining and these panels are giving the most. That's a perfect match between consumption and production. So you don't even need a battery. You could nearly wish to cast together the air conditioner, the inverter and the panels together in one monoblock, because they fit so well to each other. Okay, don't try that, please. Hey, a quick thing before we see if this setup is really able to keep me cool. I made a free little PDF for you, 15 heatwave tricks that you can start today, not just with only technology, but also smart habits that saved me hundreds on electricity. You can download it below. And of course, give me a like, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so the algorithm of YouTube knows that I'm not talking to the walls. Does it work? Look at this. It's now green. That's not good. The solar is pumping out 600 watts. That's the max of the microinverter. That would be the normal situation. In reality, I had not yet the time to install these panels on the structure, on the metal structure on the balcony. So they had to suffer this linear shadow. And that is a serious setback for a solar panel. But I will soon do that. And you know, when I do that, it will take just a full sun and then it will give its full power. Well, okay, AC is consuming 700 watts. So in the normal case, you have 700 watts of consumption against 600 watts of production. And that means that I am only buying a small fraction from the grid for a few hours that air conditioning is really working. But in the most of the time, it will just maintain the temperature. And then you have bonus energy for other consumers. So in this way, I think you can certainly say you are saving 100% on the consumption of the air conditioner, because sometimes it will be a little bit less, sometimes it will be more, and then you can supply energy to other consumers. And so let's say that you have a zero energy air conditioning. So that was my claim, that you have free energy for the next 25 years of this air conditioner, which is also a heat pump, by the way, in the winter. But take care. You remember from video 100 that you better avoid consuming less than the production. That is the reason that I made that video about integrating the microinverter with the battery. And in order to avoid that it goes to the wrong side of the meter, you can add consumption which is rather steady in the time. So let's say you are charging something, a tool, an e-bike, or even an electric vehicle. Why this is so smart? Air conditioning is a big consumer. So that means that your solar system needs expensive batteries, right? No. As I said, you can run this so-called solar PV system with air conditioner as a combination. You need the power for the air conditioner at the same time as the sun is shining and causing the heat load. It's a perfect match between consumption and production. It means not only saving money on the electricity bill, but also on the purchase, on the investment. You have also other benefits. If your air conditioner's consumption is covered, it means that you have more remaining capacity of your grid connection for other consumers. So you don't have to switch off the washing machine and you can use your hair dryer without putting the house in the dark. Even with the air conditioner running, you will be also less concerned with a problem that I described in video 100, that the production can go to the wrong side of the meter. Because the production is high, then also the consumption is high. And plus, because I oversized the panels, then you will have more hours in the year with a decent amount of production of watts. For example, with the reduced solar radiation, let's say 50% of intensity, like it could be in the morning, the evening, or also in the winter, then I get still 200 watts. The negative side is, of course, that you don't have always the full power of the solar panels. But the price was very good. And it's not so that if you buy a smaller panel, that you always pay a much better price. So, for example, during a sunny day in the winter, the PV might even give a decent contribution to the air conditioner, if this can work also reverse, like a heat pump. And as I said, this very affordable air conditioner, that is the case. Anyway, there are 9 months beyond these 3 whole months where the air conditioner is not needed, but you have other consumers. So it's nice to have this combination of these panels with the microinverter. Of course, if the air conditioner doesn't consume much, I also hug my frozen PET bottles, PET bottles from last week's video. That's cheap storage, my friends, useful to keep safe the food during a blackout, but is also a way to grab the solar energy that wants to go abroad during high production and low consumption. So you just increase the consumption in a useful way. So yes, that was my claim. 268 euro panels. One Hoymiles HM600. A sunny day and our air conditioner is free. The sun pays my cooling bill. That's nice. If you want more hacks, more experiments, or if you want to watch me breaking the rules in the name of science, subscribe and hit the bell. Stay cool, stay clever, and see you next time.